Alrighty, welcome to a modern video here on channelfireball.com. We're playing Neobrand today. This is the Neoform Eldritch Evolution deck that tries to turbo out Allosaurus Rider and turn it into a Gristlebrand. This is the hardcore version of the deck. One Gristlebrand. If you ever draw the Gristlebrand, you cannot win. But, you know, what's life without a little risk? The whole point of the deck is to basically use cards like Once Upon a Time, Summoner's Pact, Manamorphose, fast mana like Simeon Spirit Guide and Chancellor, and just get out an Allosaurus Rider, which you can cast by exiling two green cards, and then cast an early Neoform or Evolution, turn it into Gristlebrand, draw a bunch of cards off Gristlebrand, Nourishing Shoal, which lets you exile Autothon Worm or Chancellor of the Tangler Allosaurus Rider to gain a bunch of life, continue to Gristlebrand, and then eventually cast Lab Maniac off a bunch of Simeon Spirit Guides, Manamorphose, and then deck yourself with Gristlebrand or some combination of like the cantrips. You've got one copy of Life Goes On, which is a one mana gain eight if you've sacrificed a wild Cantor this turn, or actually since you sacrificed anything to Neoform or Eldritch Evolution, that works too. And you know, the one Veil of Summer is your slight concession to having a main deck opposing counterspells. The sideboard's pretty streamlined too. Four Dissenters, Deliverance, the best way to kill cards that are trying to stop your combo without being a dead draw. Slaughter Pact against problematic creatures. Leyline against discard and burn. And then Pact of Negation, Veil, and Spell Pierce against counters. All right, let's hop into League and see how this goes. Alrighty, time for round one. My opening hand has the Neoform, has fast mana, has Nourishing Shoal. Doesn't have Allosaurus Rider, but with four copies of Allosaurus Rider and four Summoner's Packs, this is the kind of hand I advocate keeping, especially on the play. Here, I don't even need to cast Wild Cantor, because Sanctum plus Gemstone Mine do enough to cast this Neoform that I can just go Botanical Sanctum, go. And, well, if we draw Allosaurus Rider, this is presumably a turn two kill. Same with Summoner's Pact. Also, by not playing Wild Cantor, we open the door for us drawing Once Upon a Time and being able to cast it for free. Alright, Snow Covered Island and Mishra's Bauble, huh? Hopefully we draw a Gristlebrand here. Oh, there's an Allosaurus Rider, so let's go Allosaurus Rider, exiling Life Goes On and Wild Cantor. Then we're going to cast Neoform here. Sack Allosaurus Rider. Ooh, get Gristlebeezy. Here we go. Draw seven. Draw seven. Yeah, this is great. Here you kind of want to like Summoner's Pact just to clear out your deck before drawing more cards. And it doesn't matter once you've gotten the Autothon Worm. Cast Shoal, exiling Worm. Draw seven. And you do have a little bit to worry about where you want to... Well, I'm not casting Autothon Worm. You want to make sure that you don't end up in a spot where you can't deck yourself with Lab Maniac because there's a weird number of cards left. But in this particular case, it's actually going to work out fine. Do I have the Lab Maniac yet? I do, even. So this is a guaranteed win here. 21 cards left. All right, seven cards left. I could just Shoal again with Chancellor of the Tangle, and then go Simeon Spirit Guide, Simeon Spirit Guide, Simeon Spirit Guide, into Manamorphose, boop, getting blue, and then I guess they can't kill my Lab Maniac. Play Gristlebrand, draw seven, and wha-bam! The turn two win, just like we drew it up. Playing against Island here, so in the dark, boarding in Pact of Negations. And, well, it's tough because they have the Mishra's Bauble does indicate they're an Urza deck more than an Astrolabe deck. So that means that I might want a couple copies of Dissenter's Deliverance as well. And then Veil of Summer. It's just not 100% clear which direction it is. One thing that's annoying about Veil of Summer is that a lot of people are playing Aether Gust these days, so you can't always rely on Veil. Side out, you basically trim some of the cantrips here because you're less. These are slots that just make it a little easier to kill once you have everything going, but they're not mandatory. You basically just can't touch the main core of the deck, including Wild Cantor here. So I think I just take out the Veil. I put in a Pact of Pierce to Dissenter's Deliverance, and then when we get more information, well, we can change up what we've got here. Alrighty, welcome to game two. What do we got? So turn one, we can play Allosaurus Rider, and you know, if we draw a land, we get to Eldritch Evolution, because we've got one mana off Chancellor, one mana off Sivian Spirit Guide. Even another Spirit Guide will do it thanks to Mana Morpha. So I think I just keep this hand and reveal Chancellor to kick things off. And hope that we draw a land or I suppose another Simeon Spirit Guide. All right, here's an Astrolabe. So they're not going to be able to stop us on turn one here. Also, past turn one, our mana goes away thanks to Chancellor of the Tangle. But here we go, the turn one kill. Exile Simeon Spirit Guide, exile Simeon Spirit Guide. Here's the only tense part. I've got a Mana Morphos, and if I draw Gristlebrand, I lose. not a Gristlebrand, sadly. Cast Allosaurus Rider, exiling Summoner's Pact and Chancellor of the Tangle. You'd rather keep the Nourishing Shoal. Evolution. Get Gristlebrand. Whoop. Draw seven. Summoner's Pact to go get my Autothon Worms. And draw another seven. Nourishing Shoal, Pitching Worm. And that'll do it. Bam. We won game round one, and our opponent took a total of two turns in the entire match. This is a magic like Garfield intended. Alrighty, welcome to round two. This hand, so first of all, it's a mulligan because of the Gristlebrand of the opening hand. The question is, would I keep this otherwise? I actually don't think so, because it's the rider's less important than having Eldritch Evolution or Neoform, because you've got four rider, four summoner's pact, and four once upon a time. So I'm going to go ahead and mulligan this hand. Luckily, after a mulligan, you can always put the Gristlebrand back. This hand on six, I think, is keepable. I still need to hit draw Neoform or Eldritch Evolution, but I have the Allosaurus Rider. I'm going to keep this hand, and I'm going to put a Nourishing Shoal on the bottom here and reveal Chancellor. And it's all scary to your opponent. You shuffle up, you keep your opening hand. Your opponent's like, all right, I have a pregame action. I'll reveal Chancellor of the Tangle. You just know they're up to some nonsense. No one ever put this card in their deck because they wanted to play a fair game of Magic. What are we going to do here? We're going to draw for a turn. Cast Once Upon a Time and see what we hit. Hopefully we play against an aggressive deck. This deck kind of preys on fast decks that can't interact. Unfortunately, decks with Thoughtseize are not that. I could fire off Once Upon a Time in response. I don't think that's good. This hand's actually pretty solid against Thoughtseize. It's got a land and a Serum Visions, and they can take my Summoner's Pack, but then Once Upon a Time maybe can still hit Allosaurus Rider. I don't care if they take Nourishing Shoal. I guess they could take Serum Visions here. Especially for having mulliganed and then getting Thoughtseized. I really don't mind this hand so much. Let's see what my opponent settles on taking. Really the only things that I think make a lot of sense are Serum Visions or Pact. Serum Visions is the best at helping me find Eldritch Evolution or Neoform. So I kind of imagine they want to take this. But especially if you haven't battled against the deck a ton, I could see just taking Summoner's Pact, because that's just clearly the combo card, and clearly you got to take the combo cards, you know? All right, well, they took the Summoner's Pact to no great surprise. Let's see what we get here. The Summoner's Pact does... Taking the Summoner's Pact is the safest in the sense that it stops my turn one kills, because if I just drew a Neoform, then I would just have a kill on turn one here. I think it's probably worth just casting Once Upon a Time and seeing where we're at. All right, so there's an Allosaurus Rider. Sadly, chipping two Neoforms here. So I'm going to take the Allosaurus Rider. And the question is, do I want a Mana Morphos before casting Serum Visions? Because I can play Serum Visions, but I have a Chancellor of the Tangle mana that's going away. So I think I want a Mana Morphos here. Add blue. And then Serum Visions to Wild Kantor, which I can't cast because I got blue, but that's fine. I wouldn't even really need to cast this. And then pass. I could play Allosaurus Rider. I actually wonder if I'm supposed to just run out Allosaurus Rider there. The problem is if it dies to removal, that's just so bad for me. But getting Thoughtseize is also pretty bad. So perhaps I am supposed to just run it out. There's not that much that can actually kill it. All right, so they took my Allosaurus Rider. So it looks like we're playing against Jund. I would just be worried about getting Liliana or whatnot. And here's where Waterlogged Grove is real strong. Lets me cycle away here. So I'm probably just going to crack Waterlogged Grove end of turn. We're entering the danger zone. Once it's turn two and you haven't killed them yet, this deck's prospects diminish rapidly. This is a win on turn one or two or basically don't win deck for the most part. And had we played out the Rider, they could have just like Liliana'd at this turn or something. I guess we could have maybe played Wild Kantor also. Doesn't seem like that's a winning maneuver. Let's see what their turn three is. All right, they do have Liliana. And they're going to plus it. I think I discard my Wild Kantor here. And I guess I crack Waterlogged Grove. I'm in quite a bit of trouble, though. There's a Once Upon a Time. Yeah, we're not getting there. All right, so a well-timed Thoughtseize got us, but you know, we never actually found the other piece, so it didn't matter too much. All right, we definitely want all the Veils of Summer. Those are certainly the best here. And once again, taking out Edge of Autumn, Life Goes On. And you don't want to cut Wild Kantor, so I guess you're just kind of forced to cut Once Upon a Times here, basically. And I don't think I want Spell Pierce either. Oh, I get to put in one card back. I don't right now have Dissenter's Deliverance in my deck. If they play a Grafdigger's Cage, I just straight up lose. But until I know they have that, I guess there's no real way for me to find out they have that without dying to it, but I still think I'd rather just have the four Veil of Summers, and I don't think you want to trim down the contents of the deck too much more past that. All right, time for game two. I would like to play first, and what do we got here? Turn one. Wow, I don't have Allosaurus Rider or Neoform, so that's no good. So here I've got the Neoform, but I don't have anything else, and I have like a million Chancer of the Tangles. This hand is fairly bad against Thoughtseize. I mean, any hand without Veil is going to be pretty bad against Thoughtseize. I think I'm going to mull one more time here. And okay, do I have enough cards to do this turn one? I don't think I do. I'm really close. Well, I get to pitch. Actually, wait. I get to pitch. So I get to put back. If I put back, let's see. If I put back like the two summoners packs. Oh man, this was a turn one kill on the play here. But I need to keep Waterlogged Grove, Simian Spirit Guide, and Chancer of the Tangle. I need to keep Eldritch Revolution and Allosaurus Rider. So, what do I do here? I mean, I'm certainly keeping the hand. The question is, how do I make this work? Because I am a card short, and there's no way to really get by that. If this was a neo form, then I could just put back the Simian Spirit Guide. But it unfortunately is not. So, what I might do here is just play turn one Allosaurus Rider. Yeah, I think that's the plan. So I'll keep this hand, play Waterlogged Grove and Allosaurus Rider. And yeah, so I'm going to keep this hand, put back, I guess I put back Eldritch Evolution under this plan. Or I could put back two. Yeah, I guess I'll put back Simian Spirit Guide and Summoner's Pact. Reveal Chancellor, though, doesn't actually help me here. And then play Waterlogged Grove and this cast Allosaurus Rider, exiling these two. And then they can Thoughtseize me on turn one. But I was going to get Thoughtseized on turn one anyway. And then I really needed that to be on six instead of seven. And then hopefully, if I had another land, I would have just kept it. But funny, if I had kept like Chancellor of the Tangle, it would have been better. Ooh, an Autothon Worm. That was a good top deck. Bash them for two. When this deck goes off, it's insane. Like, my first opponent's going to walk away from their match being like, wow, I took two turns, that deck's busted. And this opponent's going to be like, well, I cast one Inquisition and they could never win the game after that. So, yeah, that was pretty cool. See what their turn two is. The problem is I don't even really have any prospects here. Croxa, make me discard Autothon Worm. Sure, that didn't do that much anyway. I guess if I draw a land, ooh, Serum Vision, there we go. If I find land and then the top card's Neoform, all right, bottom. And I'm also attacking for no real reason here. I mean, I guess I might as well. I'll take my game actions. Well, Source Rider gets in there. I wonder what exactly what the purpose of this card was. I mean, the purpose of this card now is solely to be played in this deck and be sacrificed and turned into Griselbrand. All right. Well, that was ugly, but so it was match one, and these are the two sides of the Neobrand coin. Let's head into match three. Alrighty, welcome to round three here. We're 1-1 with Neobrand, and we're going to have to mulligan this hand, unfortunately. This hand just doesn't have any of the combo pieces, and it's way too many lands. On six, wow, this hand's not keepable. It's got five lands in it, five of my 13 lands. Alright, we'll go to five here, and certainly keep this hand. Question is, what do we put back? I'm inclined to put back Nourishing Shoal and Chancer of the Tangle, because even though Simeon Spirit Guide isn't a green card, I think that I'm not going to be able to use the mana from Chancer of the Tangle on turn one, so I would like to be able to keep the Spirit Guide in hand in case I need to cast Eldritch Evolution here. Ooh, that's a card that I'll be exiling to play Allosaurus Rider most likely. Life, in fact, goes on. Let's go ahead and cast Once Upon a Time here. And follow it up with a Serum Visions. If we get really lucky, we could kill on turn two here, but we can't kill on turn one at this point. Alright. Once Upon a Time hits me. What am I even looking for here? I guess it will be Snow Covered Island. And I suppose I'll play the island and a Serum Visions. Okay, Eldritch Evolution is a start. So I'm not going to be able to kill on turn two either, so I'm going to put them both on top and pass the turn. I guess I wanted to play Waterlogged Grove on turn one in case I drew Evolution plus a green source, though it didn't work out that way, so no big deal. Playing against Black Red Kroxa. Okay, well, I can discard Simeon Spirit Guide at this point, since any way to cast Eldritch Evolution, I already have the colorless for it, so it doesn't really help a whole lot. If I get made to discard next turn, it's going to be a little ugly, though. Because I kind of need all the cards I have left at this point. I'll put Autothon Worm on. Actually, on top. I'm just planning on winning next turn. So I think having the Autothon Worm in general is something I do want. Though maybe I don't. I guess it doesn't matter. I'm going to shuffle it away with the Eldritch Evolution. By putting it on top, what I can do is if I get Kroxa again, I can discard Life Goes On. And then next turn, wait and draw Autothon Worm as a green card to pitch to Allosaurus Rider. Bone Crusher Giant? Oh, okay. That's not going to do it. All right. So now we can play Waterlogged Grove. We can play Allosaurus Rider. We can play Eldritch Evolution. This was a mold of five. And this should do the trick. I mean, we can miss from here, but it's not mega likely. We drew Shoal and Autothon Worm right away, so yeah. Then we go to four. Nourishing Shoal, exiling Autothon Worm. Draw. All right. Cast Summoner's Pact, go get another Worm. Nourishing Shoal. Exiling the Worm. Who would win? Bone Crusher Giant or one Wormy Boy? So I go down to five cards in deck, and I've got enough Simeon Spirit Guides, right? Am I missing one? I guess I'm short one Simeon Spirit Guide. It's in my bottom five cards. That's okay. We have our ways. So it's Exile Simeon Spirit Guide. Exile Simeon Spirit Guide. I don't want to cast Allosaurus Rider. Thank you very much. Cast Summoner's Pact. Get Chancer of the Tangle just to thin the deck here. Manamorphose. Oops. Did I Manamorphose and just choose red again? That didn't make any sense. Blue, red. Did I draw the last Spirit Guide yet? I have not drawn the last Spirit Guide yet. All right, Manamorphose. I have enough Manamorphoses left. This should be fine. blue, green, and then one card left. All right, we'll go to our last card. Blue, blue. Get our Simian Spirit Guide, the very last card. Play the Lab Man. Where'd you go? And then I can cycle Edge of Autumn by sacking a land, and bam, there we go. A turn 3 win on a mold of 5 after, well, being forced to discard a card, but not in the way that we really care about. All right, so putting in the Veils once again. And again, the question is, do I want to put in like a Dissenter's Deliverance in case they have like Grafdigger's Cage or something like that? I think that's, this matchup seems decent enough with 4 Veils that I think I'd rather have one Dissenter's Deliverance instead of one Once Upon a Time here, just in case. Alrighty, time for game 2. We're on the draw here. What do we have? We've got a bunch of mana, and we've got Summoner's Pacts, but we don't have Neoform or Eldritch Evolution. I think we can mulligan this hand. Okay, I like this hand a lot more. I'll keep this. Put back a Nourishing Shoal. And then now, if we get Duressed on turn 1, which there's a decent chance that we do, we get to have a Veil of Summer up on turn 2. They'll take Eldritch Evolution, but Veil is just a great card against them. Oh, they're going to Surgical me now? Okay. I guess I don't have any more Eldritch Evolutions. If I had an Allosaurus Rider in my opening hand, I would have just lost the game on turn 1. So now, this makes it a little less likely that I win here. Just because I can no longer draw Eldritch Evolution, I have to draw one of... Basically, I have to draw one of 4 Neoforms, and I have to draw an Allosaurus Rider. But, gotta believe in the heart of the cards here. Let's see. Plus, at the end of the day, I get to be on the play in game 3. Alright, let's just play the Waterlogged Grove. It gives them info that I have Waterlogged Grove, but I think I'd rather pay a life if I were to cast Veil of Summer than sack a land of Gemstone, or take a counter off Gemstone Mine. If they croaks on me, I'm just going to discard Simian's Spirit Guide. Oh, stomp, sure. Go nuts. Alright, and... Oh, there's an Allosaurus Rider. Step 1. That's the easiest step, though. And the hardest step is certainly the Neoform. The good thing is, because it's Neoform, at this point, or bust, I don't really need this Waterlogged Grove, so I can end up cycling that away. Okay, they're going to try to kill me with Bonecrusher Giant before I find Neoform, which is certainly a possibility. Let's crack this. Draw. All right, Serum Visions. Let's just play the Botanical Sanctum first and then cast Serum Visions. And let's see what we hit. Summoner's Pact. Oh, there's the Neoform. So let's put Veil on the bottom, Neoform on top. Wait, can I do that? I can do this turn, actually, right? I can Simian Spirit Guide, Manamorphose into green-blue. Yeah. Wow. There we go. So let's get green and blue. And then we can play Allosaurus Rider, Exile, and Veil of Summer, and Summoner's Pact. And then we can cast Neoform, sacrificing Allosaurus Rider. And even if they have another Surgical Extraction, which it feels like they kind of do, it doesn't really matter here. Like, they can Surgical my Manamorphose. It does mean I can't win in one turn. Oh, no, actually, that's not even true, because I have Wild Kantor. So, anyway, I haven't exiled that one yet. So, and I have 3 Simian Spirit Guides left. So, yeah, this seems like we could still be fine here. Also, it's not clear that they can beat a Gristlebrand in play. Nothing makes me go for it this turn. I haven't used Summoner's Pact. Though I am now, but I think I should be safe because, yeah, I drew double Shoal there. Let's get Autothon Worm. Let's get under 4 here. Let's Nourishing Shoal, exiling Zewurm. Go down to 12. All right, there's another Summoner's Pact. Let's go and get my last Autothon Worm. I guess at some point I'm going to need the Wild Kantor, so maybe... And whatever. I should be able to draw enough of the cards here. All right, let's Summoner's Pact. Into Wild Kantor. Nourishing Shoal, exiling that. And am I short a Simian Spirit Guide here? Is that accurate? I guess I can pay 7 life. And then here's where it gets like a little risky, but I found the Simeon Spirit Guide. So Simeon Spirit Guide. There should be one more hiding over here. Is there not? I thought I drew the other one. Yeah, oh, there it goes. All right, Simeon Spirit Guide. Oof, got me scared for a second. Wild Cantor, abusing hybrid mana. Sack this for blue. Play the Lab Man. And 13, 3 cards left. Bam, pay 7 life. And look at that. The turn 3 win. And that was through Thoughtseize into Surgical and another Surgical, which, again, did not get me there. So let's move to round 4. Alrighty, welcome to round 4. And note, I have lost the last 2 die rolls. This deck does a lot worse on the draw. Well, there's a Grisome Rend. Had to mulligan that. Though this hand was already a mulligan. 4 lands or 3 lands and a Chancellor is just too much. So we will be shipping this one. And hopefully we get paired against like Burn at some point. Because those are the matchups that this deck excels in. All right, I'm going to mulligan. So we have Allosaurus Rider, Chancellor of the Tangle. Yeah, this is a keeper. And we'll put Lab Man back. At some point... I mean, it's the bottom card, but when you go off, you all shuffle, so it kind of doesn't matter that Lab Maniac's the bottom card. I give up the game here by revealing Chancellor of the Tangle. This is a turn 1 kill if I draw a Neoform, which is nice. And it's a potential turn 2 kill if I Serum Visions into it. Let's see what we can find. Alright, that's not a Neoform, sadly. Let's go Snow-Covered Island into Serum Visions. Metamorphose, I do not want Waterlogged Grove or Allosaurus Rider. And I will pass the turn. Don't think I'm supposed to run out the Allosaurus Rider here. So I don't know what my top card is. I also don't know what I'm playing against. They didn't crack Bloodstained Mire. Scalding Tarn. I'm like pretty suspicious here, but I don't know that I'm supposed to do anything different here. I'm just gonna Serum Visions instead of Metamorphose. I think that's fine. I don't feel that in a hurry to cycle Metamorphose. All right, well, there's a Neoform. Pass the turn, and next turn, if we're playing against Death Shadow, we get to go off without getting Stubborn Denialed, which is nice. I don't know what other brews are playing Bloodstained Mire plus Scalding Tarn. But they have had no cantrip so far and no hand disruption. So yeah, I can't. Oh, Dwarven Mine. We're playing against the Improvised Creativity or whatever that nonsense is deck. That's pretty funny. So let's play my land. Let's play Allosaurus Rider, exiling the Chancellors here. Oh man, am I going to get remanded? Kind of feels like I am, but this is not a play-around cards kind of deck. So here they go. So if they remand me, they really want to remand the Neoform, not the Allosaurus Rider. Because if they remand the Allosaurus Rider, I can actually just replay it and then Neoform. I guess it's pretty juicy to get to remand Allosaurus Rider, though. And how their deck works is they don't have any creatures in the deck except Emrakul, and they use Dwarven Mine to go to make a creature, and then they play the X red, like kind of polymorph spell. Oof, my opponent has not battled against this deck, and this should not have worked, but it did, and we should be able to win now. I mean, we're down a Nourishing Shoal, but I still like my chances here, especially since I have a lot of mana. So I don't necessarily need to find every single piece. All right. Oh yeah, I found other shoals and both worms. There we go. Whew. That was pretty lucky. We could have really ended up losing there. All right, so we have 5 cards left. And we found the Lab Man. And Simeon Spirit Guide. Laboratory Maniac. And Simeon Spirit Guide. Do I have a Life Goes On somewhere? Oh, I have a Nourishing Shoal. That works. And let's exile Allosaurus Rider and then pay 7 life to Gristle Brandon. Well, bam! We got there through a remand, but again, we kind of stole a march there. All right. I do want Spell Pierce. I don't think I necessarily want Dissenter's Deliverance here. Let's see. We can definitely take out Life Goes On, Edge of Autumn, and some Once Upon a Times. And I think Veil of Summer is going to be decent over Pact of Negation. All right, let's try this. Alrighty, game two here. On the draw, I do have Allosaurus Rider and Eldritch Evolution, but I don't have a whole lot of other green cards. I still think this is probably fine, though. It just has the combo, and yes, I would like to draw, you know, Veil of Summer or something like that, but or maybe some acceleration here. Oh, Neoform's not bad. Neoform is kind of like drawing an accelerant. If they pass with mana up, I don't know that I feel good about going for Neoform. But if they play something, then maybe we could do it. Stomping Ground. Okay. Hopefully they don't have a hate card because I can't beat any of those. Farseek? Oh, okay. Cool. I get to kill them. I like that. I mean, I guess they could have Force of Negation, but what can you do? Can't live life in fear. That is definitely not the motto of this deck. Like, I could just draw Gristlebrand this turn and I would be dead. I would just concede on the spot. Kind of hoping I do, to be honest. All right, Allosaurus Rider, Eldritch Evolution, Neoform, yoink, yoink, yoink. Ooh, got a bunch of shoals. Let's go ahead and cast Summoner's Pact. And oh, my opponent has had enough. Gristlebrand wins again. Bam, a little turn two kill there. Let's see how round five goes and see if we can, we're at 31 minutes, see if we can get this video to under 40 with a full five rounds. Awesome. Alrighty, welcome to round five. I did win the die roll this time, so I guess I can't complain about that. Heh, we'll see about that. Here we've got a lot of mana and a lot of cycling cards, but neither of the combo pieces, so this is not going to do it. Here we have no lands. Oh, this is unfortunate, because I have Evolution Allosaurus Rider, but no lands? No, I think that's not great. Here, I have a turn... Wait, This is a turn one kill on a five-card hand. And we even get to put Gristlebrand on the bottom. It doesn't matter which one of those I put on, because look, I get to reveal... both Chancellors. Chancellor is so good in the deck. I get to reveal both Chancellors and then play Allosaurus Rider off the two Chancellors. And then I play Evolution. All right. Exile. Allosaurus Rider. Land. Boom. Oh, no big deal. The Mulligan actually good there. Let me put my this five card hand was better than seven. Look at that. Turn one win, because if my seven card hand had that Gristlebrand, I couldn't have kept it. Don't know what I'm playing against. So in the dark, I actually do believe you should side in a couple Dissenter's Deliverances, because on balance you're gonna play against people with some ways to disrupt you that are artifacts, and if they don't, well, you could just cycle it, and it really is not that big of a deal. I think Edge of Autumn is the weakest there. All right, let's see how this goes. All right, well, I'm going to keep this hand, because this is also a turn one win. Let's see if my poor opponent will have taken one turn this entire match. They're mulliganing, but I get to go turn one, Allosaurus Rider pitching Evolution and Chancellor. Oh, no, Pluto Delta. Well, I'm just going to go for it. What am I going to do, right? Do I even want to use Once Upon a Time? Feels like... Yeah, I mean, I guess so. Why not? Oh, I guess that's why not. Whatever. Allosaurus Rider, Exiling Chancellor, and Eldritch Evolution. Land, Exile Simian Spirit Guide, Evolution, Sack Allosaurus Rider. You got the Spell Pierce? They have it or they don't. Oh, man. My opponent just said, sure, dude, go play Legacy. I love it. I can taste the salt from here. To be honest, they took one turn that entire match, so I can understand where they're coming from, but sure, dude, go play Legacy is classic. That just sums up this deck. Sure, dude, go play Legacy. Well, I really enjoyed playing this deck. It's the opening hands, the mulligans, that's like basically all of the fun. Once you get to turn three, you're almost always dead, but you know what? Sometimes you're just in to roll the dice. The one Gristlebrand's definitely the way to go. Sideboard, I think this is the right board. I think Descender's Deliverance, Veil of Summer, basically all these cycling and one and zero mana cards are exactly what this deck wants. Can't speak to the Slaughter Pact or Spell Pierce quite yet. And I like the way the main deck's built. I think it is optimized. I don't understand the people who don't play Once Upon a Time. I think this card is better than a lot of the other random flex slots people have in the deck. All right, well, we got there in 35 minutes, five full rounds. Really can't complain, and that was a lot of fun. So make sure to join me for the next one of these videos, whether it be Modern, Pioneer, Legacy, who knows? Maybe I'll go play Legacy, Draft, and more here on channelfireball.com. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, let me know. I can make more like this for sure.